I thank you for this most generous reception and for the honor of being called upon to speak to this vast assemblage. Sure, this has been a great day for the suffragists. They've had parades and speaking and flags a-fluttering tin stars in the breezes and yellow banners that scare some people worse than a smallpox sign. They've had picnics and banquets and soap boxes on the corners. They wore sunflowers and sang them noble words of Patrick Henry. Give me votes for women or give me death. But if Patrick Henry was a senator today, he'd say, for the love of my, give them women votes before they talk us to death. Words like them is what Patrick Henry'd be saying if he was here today, and sure the country needs them. What the suffragists want most of all is to have the Constitution of the United States amended so as to enfranchise all of the women of the country to once, instead of going from door to door and state to state, asking them in,
have you any ballots you could spare a poor woman who hasn't had a ballot to bite since she left the state of Colorado?
Why, ladies and gentlemen, do you know that after every election, New York State prints in the papers 3 times as many ballots as there are men registered? But do you think they'd give the poor women any of them?
No!
Not on your life. Now, what the women want is to vote, and by golly, they ought to. At the present time, women is voting in the frozen wilds of Alaska and the blistering Philippines. They have the vote in 10 states now, and pending in 8 more, and trembling in the balance in 5 others. It'll not be long now till 1916, and it may be that a man will be elected without tripping on a suffrage plank in his platform. But take it from me, ladies and gentlemen, and the plank will be there. Now, in conclusion, let me say, it's going to be ladies first in times of danger, with all parties playing at funds and gas stand before them. Thank you.